Vabbè, non è mai visto come sono. I might tell you the tiny of it. Don't you look at that? Ran to fucking politicians you gotta vote for. And no matter which one you vote for, if you're a drug addict, you will continue to be exploited by these bastards. And you will continue to live in slavery with no human rights whatsoever. Your children will be taken off you because the cops will make up shit about uncapped fits around the place. The cops will spear docs in, doc spears the cops in, you know. A bunch of fags out at fucking Department of Child Stealing and just fucking decide to steal your kids and adopt them off to fucking gay couples. Really. Someone's got to do something about this. It's atrocious. The DEA made the drug laws up. It was a racist way of keeping black and Hispanic people oppressed in the 1930s. It's been a get-rich-quick scheme for them. It has spread drugs across the whole planet where no drug problem existed previously. The laws aren't legal because to pass the laws, it implies that the state owns the rights to your mind. If it owns your mind, it owns your body, it owns the lot of you. You don't exist as an entity that's able to be self-determining with drug laws. And this is why addicts are totally fucked. The drug laws are designed to fucking break their spirit, drive them to suicide, and quite often to poison them with illegal fucking drugs that are shonky, fucking cut with all sorts of stuff. Because the DEA is nothing but a bunch of war criminals, murderers, intent on contaminating drugs, making the price high, and making addicts unable to live. They know they can't give up, so they keep trying to price it to the point where they'll suicide. And a few of my friends have suicided because they couldn't afford the drugs they needed. It is a disgusting thing to know about. But people in such desperation and unable to get something will take their own lives. And there's a bunch of people out there, the DEA, rubbing their hands together with joy over this. These people are sick. They're war criminals. They deserve to be tried in an international court. And if convicted, be executed like any people that betray their own. Because our politicians declared a drug war on us addicts. We have no political representation, we have no guns, we have no means of fighting back, and they declared a war on us. We're medically unfit to be in an army, never mind have a war declared on us. And what for? Having an illness this society caused. If the police had done their job and stopped us becoming addicts by stopping the drugs like we've been pretending to do for 85 years, we could have never got addicted. But that's not the game they're playing. They want people addicted. They want to spread the problem. And everything they do is designed to spread that problem. From strip searches to jailing people, taking them away from their families, busting their families up, keeping them in poverty. It's all designed to reinforce how hopeless their lives are and that they might as well continue to take drugs. Especially once they've got a criminal record, because they can't get a job. And it's pretty hard to spend the whole of your life without a job, without taking drugs or something. This society is playing a dirty game on sick people. And you bastards are just as guilty because you have done nothing to fight for the rights of your brothers and sisters who are being held in slavery. What kind of weak morons are you? When they pass some new law that stops you doing what you want, we'd be prepared to stand up for you, but yous won't stand up for us. And a lot of the people that are drug addicted are just so fucking low self-esteem, they actually think they deserve to be treated like shit. It is fucking horrible, you know? Most of these people are fucking homeless, they've got nothing, And the only reason they're like that is because of the intolerant attitudes to their brothers and sisters out there that think they are worthless. If anyone's worthless, it is the fucking judges, the politicians, and the senior police who are all taking advantage of drug-addicted prostitutes. That's the real reason we won't change the drug laws, because these bastards are exploiting your sons or daughters as sex slaves for drugs. Come on, do something about it. Someone, somewhere. Circulate this to your friends. The whole planet has to do something about this. If you give us cheap, clean drugs, we'll give you 80% less crime. We'll stop the spread of the drug problem. We'll make it fucking contracting on itself. And we'll free up some of the best brains on the planet that are locked inside the skulls of junkies. Come on, you people out there. Stop being apathetic. We're living in slavery while you do nothing. Some of you must have seen Abraham Lincoln. You know, he freed the slaves. And what happened? A few years later, DEA fucking brought these laws in to stop black and Hispanic men sleeping with white women and playing satanic swing music. What a fucking backpedal. What a illegal fucking act that was. Yet no one actually fucking studies it. Come on, do something. You know? Give this to your friends. Circulate it. Fucking demand politicians do something. Especially demand that they look at Michael Wilson in the Downing Centre on the 14th of February, where I argued that the drug laws aren't legal. Make them have a look. Our lives depend on it. Thank you.